In this video, we're gonna look at how I took these photos with the 7Artisans 60mm f2.8 macro lens. What's special about this lens is that it is very cheap, around $200 or 200 British pounds, which is probably the cheapest macro lens that I know of that goes from infinity to 1x magnification. And it is available for basically all mirrorless camera systems. One thing that shocked me a bit when I unboxed this lens was how this pipe here basically protrudes when you focus very close. Quite a peculiar construction. Otherwise it feels very well built, all out of metal, and it feels pretty solid, and it does not feel cheap in its build quality. It feels like a pretty expensive lens actually. There are no clicks on the aperture wheel, and that is kind of good if you're doing video. I don't really care, I don't miss the clicks, but it's good to know. And another thing you will notice is if you use this on a full frame camera, you will get these extremely heavy vignetting on full close-ups on like 1x magnification and also on infinity. So this is definitely a lens for APS-C sensors or smaller. So I decided to shoot in APS-C mode on my Sony A7 III. So I went to the Bergianska garden, as I often do when I want to shoot some macro. And for warm-up I did some photography without a flash. The pictures come out very sharp. There are no problems with sharpness in this lens at all. It is sharp on all apertures. What does bother me a bit though is that the areas between what is in focus and out of focus look a bit ugly. They look milky and cheap, and I will explain more about this later when I show you some more sample shots. So this is a shot without flash at f2.8, and it is absolutely tack sharp. I took many shots and all of them are very very sharp at f2.8 and also at all the other apertures I tested. After a while I brought out my flash and diffuser to take some more shots at smaller apertures and with good light of insects. On this day it was quite cold, but still there were some bees and other insects out, so I figured why not use the macro lens to photograph them. This lens is fully manual, it contains no electronics at all, so you don't get any aperture or other EXIF information into your camera, and of course it's completely manual focus. But if you know me, you know that that is how I like it. I don't like to focus any other way than manually, and yeah, it is a bit sad not to get EXIF information, but that is not something I would expect from a $200 lens anyway. So funny enough, the lens has written on its package that it has a 26cm minimum focus distance, which sounds very good, but I mean the working distance is not very long because this pipe that sticks out, especially when you focus closely, so do not expect to be able to have the lens 26cm away from your subject. It is merely your sensor that will be that far away. So let's talk about what I don't like in the image quality. If you look at this photo, you can see that what's in focus is extremely sharp, and that's good. But look where this arrow points, and where this other arrow points. You can see that the area where it goes from focus to out of focus looks very milky and blurry in a bad way. This looks very cheap, I would say, and I really don't like the look of this. So in many photos I felt they were a bit ruined because of this characteristic in the optics. But on the other hand, this is the only bad thing I have to say about optics. Otherwise they are really good and the photos come out very good and very sharp. And yeah, I like the optics. I didn't test them for distortion or anything, and that is simply because I don't care about distortion that much with macro lenses. I photograph insects anyway and not Lego bricks, so any distortion would not really be that visible. One thing to note with all the photos you're seeing in this video is that they were shot with APS-C or Super 30 mode in my Sony a7 III full frame camera, which means that they are very low resolution. My sensor is 24 megapixels in total, and in APS-C mode it becomes only 10 megapixels because it's basically a cropped 24 megapixel full frame sensor. And despite all the photos you see in this video are only 10 megapixel, I think they came out pretty good. I also did a few shots on longer distances than full magnification, and the lens performs very well on all focusing distances. Even if you're shooting a bird from a few meters away, or if you shoot into the horizon, all distances and all apertures seem to be very sharp with this lens. So, who is the 7Artisans 60mm f2.8 macro lens for then? I think it is for anyone who has a mirrorless camera, because it exists for all mirrorless mounts, from Micro Four Thirds to APS-C mounts like Canon EF-M or Sony E-mount that I'm using. And it is for anyone with any of these mounts that want a really, really cheap macro lens that can give you anything from infinity to 1x magnification for only $200. If you have more money to put on a macro lens, I would maybe invest them in the Lauva 60mm, because that one goes to 2x and it has, according to me, nicer image quality. It has a much nicer bokeh, and the zones between focus and autofocus do not look weird as with the 7Artisans lens. But the Lauva 60mm, on the other hand, it costs $400, so it's double the price of the 7Artisans. So for $200 you get a lot of macro lens with the 7Artisans lens. So I would recommend it if that is your budget. Don't forget to sign up to my free email newsletter. It comes out once a month and it contains inspiration, tips about great photographers, about great podcasts and photography gear, and anything inspiring related to photography goes on up at mwroll.com. And please leave a like and do subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to check out my Instagram account for more of my work. That's it for this video. See you soon again. Over and out.